In this video, I am going to explain relationship between concussion and deep part of brain. Particularly, I'm going to focus on membrane of brain. I mean, how membrane affects deep part of brain. Mainly, I'm going to talk about brain membrane that separates right brain and left brain. This membrane is Falux cerebri. Falux cerebri. Falux means sickle. You know, sickle as blade. And cerebri means brain. So membrane of brain that separates right brain and left brain. Then, when concussion happens, your brain is shaken for many directions, maybe anterior, posterior, side to side, maybe up to down. Where does this falux cerebri attaches to? The superior part attaches to skull. Inferior part attaches to, you see this part? This is corpus callosum. Corpus callosum kind of connects right brain and left brain. These two hemispheres communicate via corpus callosum. This is very important place. Let's review structure. This blue part is falux cerebri, membranous system, right? The yellow part is corpus callosum. This communicates right and left brain. Very important place. Then what happens if you got concussion? Then your brain is shaken when concussion happens, but this membrane doesn't move a lot. Then imagine your brain moves, brain is shaken. What happens to this kind of attachment place between corpus callosum and falux cerebri? There is shearing force here. Shearing force is like two surfaces kind of shear, literally shear, moves different direction. Membrane doesn't move, but brain moves. Then there is shearing force. Then what happens? This shearing force puts a lot of stress on corpus callosum. Therefore, there is chance that corpus callosum degenerate or corpus callosum deforms nervous cells. According to the book, textbook of traumatic brain injury, 3rd edition, when there is severe concussion, the data says there is serious degeneration in corpus callosum. Of course, the concussion itself degenerate brain tissue, but I was surprised that how membrane of brain kind of puts a lot of stress on brain tissue. Again, falux cerebri attaches to corpus callosum. When concussion happens, there is shearing force, okay, between falux cerebri and corpus callosum. Therefore, nervous fiber, nervous tissues of corpus callosum degenerate. Very important. Now, let me explain one more place related to falux cerebri. Next place is here. It is a little bit above corpus callosum. This place is cingulate gyrus. Cingulate gyrus. Cingulate gyrus is part of limbic system. Limbic system governs emotion, memory, and learning. Okay? Then, beside cingulate gyrus, there is falux cerebri. So, concussion force can also deform cingulate gyrus. What is problem? Then people might have memory problem, emotional problem, or learning problem that may be because of this membranous structure and maybe your cingulate gyrus deforms. Plus, cingulate gyrus kind of communicates anterior, posterior place. What about corpus callosum? That is side-to-side communication, left brain and right brain. Cingulate gyrus is anterior, posterior. So, when concussion happens, because of this membrane, falux cerebri, cingulate gyrus and corpus callosum have chance to deform its nervous tissues. That's very serious thing, right? Again, this information is from a book, a textbook of traumatic brain injury. So if you are interested, I recommend you purchase this book. This is very thick book, but very informative. From now on, it's gonna be my hypothesis based on this information. Okay, this information is from the book. From now on, I'm gonna tell you my hypothesis. Okay, this is posterior view. There's falux cerebri, this part. This kind of attaches to corpus callosum. Then that can deform corpus callosum. Makes sense. Then, falux cerebri attaches to this kind of membrane. Then it splits like this. This yellow part is tentorium cerebelli. Tentorium cerebelli. This membrane separates cerebrum and cerebellum. It's a little bit confusing. Tentorium cerebelli separates cerebrum and cerebelli. Okay, then there's continuation, membranous continuation. It's kind of longitudinal membrane. This pink one is falux cerebelli. Falux cerebelli. So there are falux cerebri, tentorium cerebelli, and falux cerebelli. Okay. The book was talking about falux cerebri and corpus callosum plus cingulate gyrus. Now let me give you my hypothesis. Tentorium cerebelli separates cerebrum and cerebelli. What is function of cerebellum? That is mainly movement and balance. So what happens if there's concussion? There can be sharing force between cerebrum and cerebellum. Then what's going to happen? Maybe balance problem, maybe movement problem. What if there is stress on falux cerebelli? Also, you may have balance problem or movement issue, correct? One more thing. You see this part? This part is midbrain. Tentorium cerebelli has relationship with midbrain. Oh my gosh, midbrain is so important. There are cranial nerve number 3 and 4. They are about eye movement nerves. Then there are substantia nigra. Substantia nigra. There is red nucleus. They are important for movement control. You know, midbrain is very important. Midbrain has relationship with tentorium cerebelli. Again, what's going to happen if there's concussion? What happens if there's shearing force between tentorium cerebelli and midbrain? It's going to be a serious problem, right? Midbrain is very deep part of brain. And there are kind of a center part of movement, vision, and so many things. So concussion gives huge impact for brain. Now I focused on the membranous system, concussion, and brain tissue. There will be more research and the pathophysiology of concussion, but I hope this video gives idea of relationship among brain, concussion, and membranous system. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.